God is moving us along. And then when I got back, I get a phone call. I told my wife, you know, maybe we should be going back to LA. That's where we started. And then I get a phone call from this real big guy, he's a singer. He worked a lot with TBN. And he called me up and said, I hear you're in town. We really want you to come and do an interview with TBN. So I got that ticket. Then another ticket came for me to speak in LA. All of a sudden, all the LA connections were open. Like, this must be God. So we got our tickets, and we're going. Meanwhile, Angel's pregnant, and we go to the plane, she starts bleeding. So now we've got a situation. What's happening here? It looks very serious, you know. Shall we take a chance, get on the plane? Not that we're running from him, but it would be better if she didn't have him around, that's for sure. So we said, no, let's just go. And we went, we flew, we got there. And, long story short, she had the baby. She went to one of these homes there in California. Nothing what I expected for my daughters. I didn't expect. See, listen, life is what happens to you when you've made other plans. That's life.
Amen.
That's the real thing. You make your plans and all of a sudden it all goes. That's life.
Preach.
And how do you deal with it? Give it to who is the true life. Cast all your cares upon him. He'll care for you. And sure enough, she went through this home with all unwed mothers, and a lot of them were Christian, and she had a baby. Well, he's a big man now. He's taller than me. His name is Luke. Paul said, only Luke stayed with me. So God turns all things for good to those that love him. They're called according to his purpose. So we went to LA. Now, this can go on, so I don't want to take it too far.
Please go on.
So here I am. Okay, here I am. I'm losing everything. And I said to God, I'm just tired of this whole thing. I said, listen, if you open the door, I'll preach, but I'm not going to go to these ministers' meetings and hand out my business card and all that stuff. I just couldn't be bothered with all this. You know, I just committed all to you. At that time, the internet became on the scene. It's a while back. And so I thought to myself, I've got to get some tent-making business here. And I started to learn the internet and do some coding and all this databases and all that stuff. But then I used to say to myself, what am I doing? I remember going once to a convention of computer geeks. What am I doing here? I'm Pastor Bassett. I'm just sort of, I lost myself. So not only did I lose money, reputation, ministry, my daughter. By the way, we lost the dog too. I gave the dog to a friend. I thought it was a friend who I met in Florida. I said, listen, can you just please keep the dog? Because I can't get him on the plane as well. And I'll be back to pick him up. He said, yeah. You know what he did? He gave it to his mother. I fell in love with the dog, they wouldn't give it to me back. And so I'd have to fly from LA to Miami to go to court to try and get my dog back. And I just didn't have the resources. So my little girls, they were shocked, especially Gabby, at the Zeppelin. She loved the dog. We lost the dog. She still thinks about it. What did Paul say? I've suffered the loss of all things. You see, to go up, folks, sometimes you've got to go down. See, it's not all up. You see, you've got to be emptied first of all the old. So if you feel that everything's being taken from you, don't be too upset. Yeah, I know it's tough, but But there's a reason. Because it means God wants to take you to another level.
Yes.
See, you can't have the new being real in your life if you're filled with the old. So God's got to take you and pour you out. You can't sit there with the old information. The new is revelation. And he wants to give it to you. He wants to give you everything. If he gave his son to die for you on a cross, how much more will he give you all things freely to enjoy?
Yes.
This is real. But he's got to turn you upside down and shake all this stuff out of you. So I was getting to that point where I said, God, you know, I don't understand. So now my wife says, we got to eat. She goes, no, you're not bringing any money in. And I'm trying to work this computer thing. No, you forget it. You'll make any money on that. And then just through a series of events, I mean, just impossible to calculate, but so precise, God brought me back to the very